Good morning, Swiftfoot Falcons. Thank you, first grade, for doing our Pledge of Allegiance. This week is January 27th through the 31st. Let's go to kindergarten for the letter of the week.
Hi, my name is Daniel. I'm with Casey and Lola from Mrs. Willie's class. Can you tell me what the letter of the week is, Casey?
H.
What sound does it make? Good job. What are some things that start with H, Lola?
Hydrated.
Hydrated? That's a really long H word. What else starts with H?
Horn.
Good job. Now, what is one more thing that starts with H?
Hat.
Thank you, kindergarten.
Now to our reporter for our story highlights.
Hey, Mrs. Reynolds. How's your new year going?
It's going great so far, Daniel. Thanks for asking. What about you?
Good, thank you.
Yeah, this year, you know, new year comes around, new decade, 2020, so exciting. And what do people usually do at the beginning of the year? Have you guys heard of New Year's resolutions? Lots of people want to exercise more or lose weight as adults. There's always something like that new year gives you promise and you just want to start over. So this year, I did something instead of a resolution. I did something called one word.
One word? Tell me more about that.
Well, did you know that 87% of Americans make resolutions? It's a lot of Americans. And then by the end of January, most of those resolutions are kaput. So I decided one word. I did some research. If you can commit to this word, that will bring you like meaning going forward for the new year, then it's just a word and you can balance all the things in your life. So this is my one word, hashtag balance. That means I can balance my professional life here at school as a principal and then like not spend so much time here and spend some more time personally with my family and doing those things. It also means I can balance my diet. Like if I have 6 cookies, well, maybe I better eat 6 zucchinis to balance it out. Kind of funny, but you get the idea. So I can apply this word, this one word, to all of my life.
Cool, that sounds like a great word. Did the teachers like the activity?
Let's ask one.
Hi.
Hi.
My name's Mrs. McKinney. I loved the activity. I actually sat down and spent about 20 minutes thinking about my word because so many of these words popped into my head. But my word was fortitude. And for me, that word just meant to prepare for the future with strength. Whether that's how I'm eating or how I'm exercising or what I'm learning or what I'm thinking about with my family or my friends. It's not always about right now. Sometimes it's about what you need to do right now to get to what's happening later. So fortitude is my word, and it was a great thing for me to do.
Thanks, Mrs. McKinney.
Spruce Wood Falcons.
What would your one word be?
I don't get this. This is too hard for me. Wait, I have notes. Let's try again.
Great job persevering, Daniel. Here's the rest of your homework. Keep on persevering.
Wait, I can't do this. I'm finished.
Hi, I'm with Mrs. Avery for our Getting to Know You segment. Mrs. Avery, where did you grow up?
I grew up in Idaho, in Pocatello, Idaho.
That's nice. Where did you go to college?
I went to BYU.
That's nice. Where was your first teaching job?
It was in Idaho. I went back home, so I graduated from college and went home for 1 year, taught there, and then came back.
Nice. How long have you been at Sprucewood?
I think it's 12 years.
Nice. Where's your favorite place to vacation and why?
I have two places. So the one I go to all the time that I really love is Florida at Disney World. But if I had a choice, I'd go to London and Paris.
That's nice.
More money.
Thank you, Mrs. Avery.
Now for Sprucewood current events. The Latinos in Action will be here on Wednesday. Chick-fil-A will be here on Thursday for birthdays. And Career Day is Friday from 9 to 10:30. See you next week, Falcons.
Thanks
for
watching
the Falcon Report!